Somebody get me some water. Hi friends, namaste.
Namaste.
Namaste, my brothers, sisters, teachers.
Fellow travelers.
Fellow travelers.
Thank you. just want to say something about this song because it came out of lessons that Manaus was giving me. It's really quite a few years ago now that this happened, this particular unfolding, because we were really in the lesson and he was teaching me this rag, which means there's certain notes you can use, certain notes you can use going up, certain notes you can go going down in the scale, and which note is emphasized in the mood and everything. And so this rag, unfortunately I forget the name, he was teaching me, and then in front of my eyes the song just line by line, he just made it up line by line. It was so incredible, and it became like this perfect tailor-made song for me. I just love singing it, and it's actually in Nepali, it's not Sanskrit, it's in his own language, which is also very, very sweet for me to know and for him to hear also. And so it says, it talks about Shyam, and Shyam is the dark Krishna, when we see Krishna in his dark form, it's a certain way of
depicting
Krishna. And it says, you know, please give me your darshan, please let me see you. I just, you know, like it's such a longing and such a being open to being connected and being one with Krishna. And also an asking for it, a kind of a real reaching out. And in the last line, it says, you know, I realize that Shyam is the beloved Prabhu, is in me all along, is in me all the time. And now it has taken on a totally new meaning, because obviously there's the name Shyam in it, and our beloved Shyam Das left his body after the song was composed. So when the song happened, we didn't think like that. But now when I sing it, I feel like, oh, Shyam, Shyam, Shyam. And then, yes, and we can feel Shyam always now. He's inside of us. There's no separation and there's no longing now. There is a sweet love feeling with him. And some of you were wondering who Shyam was. He was really one of our dearest and closest friends. And left his body 5-7 years ago now, I think. And it's just it brings a smile on our faces when we think of Shyam.
Meditation?
You're not going to say anything?
Well, let's get these in tune. Just a minute. Let's get these in tune.
Matan's gonna talk to us hopefully at some point. I have this big kind of feeling inside of me since yesterday. And that is that what we are now embarking upon, even really as a humanity and each one of us, is a phase of improvisation. You know, it feels like improvisation is like written across the sky for me right now. It seems like the last 2 or 3 months were like cancellation, letting go, surrender, giving up, or, you know, like that kind of feeling. And already improvisation was coming in the last few months, because obviously we responded to that whole thing. But maybe, I don't know if that makes sense to you, but I just could see us all in a phase of improvising. And improvising is such a beautiful word, because first of all, I connected obviously with music. So in music we improvise, there's a solo, you know, there's somebody who takes a solo and their solo is improvised. It means there's no map, you know, there's no set melody. But that musician has loads of skill and experience in melody and in his life, in his, that he can bring to that improvisation. So just like us, you know, we have all these life skills and all this life experience and our own personal skills and us as a human family that we all have, and we all bring them to the table. But now we can use them fresh. We can see where do I come in, where do I take it to another level, where do I drop things, where do I just leave a pause. You know, that's also part of improvisation, is not to play and not to, you know, put another note. And also improvisation is improve in it, you know, so it's like through our improvising, through our being responding to the moment, which is what improvisation is, we improve things. And maybe I just thought maybe today with a humming, Miten and I will just hum, and you can let your voice just, you know, dance with the music, just make up some little melody that comes to you with the om or with words of your choice or with sounds that come out, just to open that channel of improvising and being ready to see what comes through me. And I have all the tools that it takes to have something come through me that now is asked for, and it can uplift myself. today we want to dedicate our Gayatri Mantra to two very close and dear friends who have birthday today that have been in our lives for a long time, and that is our beloved friend Esha from Bielefeld, who was in the beginning also, she was helping us with sending out the CDs when we just did it ourselves, you know, from a flat in Germany to put to the post office to the world. And Esha was there so sweetly supporting us, and she's such a dear friend, and it's her 50th birthday today. So Esha, happy birthday. And Mikael from Stockholm, who many, I'm sure some of you know if you're from that area, because he's such a pillar in the Sweden Sangha and creates so many beautiful events and gatherings. And so Mikael, he's also been extremely supportive to us in the beginning when we started traveling. Yeah, but also like Esha, just also very early on. So it's beautiful to be with you for such a long time. And then there is somebody we don't know. She's from Fiji, and she's called Lakshmi Gunda, and she's it's her birthday today too. And I think it's her daughter who reached out. I think a few people reached out about her to
for you, Lakshmi.
For Lakshmi. So this is
talk to Lakshmi.
Happy birthday to you, Lakshmi. And then also all our healing energies and supporting energies to Savita, who's going through some health challenges and an operation tomorrow. So Savita, we are with you and we love you and we sing for you.
Also to my buddy Sandesh G over there in Costa Rica. Sandesh, love you, man. Corfu. Begins with the same.
He's in England.
No, he's in Corfu.
Is he?
Are you in Corfu, yeah. Sandesh? Anywhere, wherever you are, man. I love you.
So, seven chakra Gayatri mantra. The difference between a seven chakra and the other one is that. Sorry,
No, it's fine. It's okay.
Is that the seven chakra spells out all the seven levels individually. You know, it addresses every one of the seven chakras individually. The other one, the short form, actually only addresses three levels. But when it gets translated, it always includes everything anyway. So it's basically none is less than the other, or less powerful, or it's just. I think it's just, you know, they're obviously different schools who say this is the one, but I feel they're all part of our lives, and we they have their place, and the basic intrinsic meaning is the same for both mantras, for both forms. Say something. I want to hear you talk.
Come on, let's sing. Let's sing.
Maybe after. Thank you.
Join with the mantra of In my heart you will always exist. Calling me on somehow. Sail away over the ocean. For love, I'm ready to fly. I was never asking for much, and I was given the sky. Sail away over the ocean, over the ocean of time. Sail Never saw the morning till I looked in your eyes. Never saw myself so clear. Clouds of loneliness all swept aside, and I watched them all disappear. Friends, take care of each other. When we were meditating there, I was feeling like consciously, while my eyes were closed, consciously connecting in the heart with my global friends, friends in this beautiful Sangha, and feeling all of us through my open heart. It's a beautiful thing. We don't need to know each other's stories, you know. We don't need to know each other's ideals and conditionings, all that is below our connection to the heart. And together we are connected with our voices in our hearts. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Focus on that.
Yeah.
And the nest is being recycled by another bird. Another
beautiful.
Bird is
beautiful to see it. There's a few little birds, I guess two, but
maybe it's a commune. Maybe
yeah,
they're building a commune.
It could be. Maybe it's a commune. Yeah. Anyway, they're taking the old nest away, and the nest where the snake was a couple of days ago, and mom and dad and the three little babies have left and gone flying out into the world. Sometimes they come back visit us. And meanwhile, their old nest is being thankfully taken apart and taken somewhere else. Where these, it's fantastic, isn't it, nature? The other little birds now are setting up a nest just behind the house there. We haven't found it yet.
Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Loka Samasta Sukhino
Namaste.
Namaste, friends. Have a beautiful day if you're down there, down under. If you're just going to bed in England, sweet dreams. And if you have the evening ahead of you, like David and I have a beautiful evening, don't forget to dance.
Mm-hmm.
Always good to have a dance after our meditations, we just discovered. Bob Marley on. Put dance when you walk.
Oh, yes.
Have a little dance. Namaste.
Namaste. Namaste.